and welcome to FX Bootcamp London. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is Friday, December 14th, 2007. This is your daily London session video. A review of just a little bit of what we did today at the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. I say a little bit because as you can see looking at our major currency scan, we had quite a night. Quite a bit of movement, quite a few pairs doing some pretty predictable retracements of Fibonacci. And then some nice extensions to the downside on the euro dollar, pound dollar, Aussie dollar, upside on the dollar Swissie, dollar yen. So instead of going over all of these in this video, keep you here for a while, I think I'll just talk about maybe euro dollar and a little bit of pound dollar. Well, this is the euro dollar at, well, let's back it up a couple candles here. Now, our London session begins at 2 a.m., so this initial breakout you see here with the Bollinger Bands opening up at just after 12:15 gives you a clue that, you know what, we're about to possibly see some sort of movement on the euro. Before I go any further, you back this out and do a fib study of the big drop we had the other day down to the 4,600 area, 4,575 to be exact. And since then, we've been sort of in an upward flag pattern, which is generally a continuation pattern in a channel here. And if you take a look, this is the 382 Fibonacci retracement level. This is the 50%. And it's converging pretty much with the top of this channel, right near the psychological level of 4650, which is just below the 200 EMA, and is also pretty much just above pretty much the central pivot point for the day. Essentially, we are hitting a lot of stuff right at the 4650 area. Now, when you go over to our weekly pivots, you'll take a quick look here and recognize that our weekly central pivot point, that's this thick line right here, okay, is also exactly 4650. So with all that in mind, let's go back to the 15-minute chart and zoom back in here. We've taken a big drop. We've bounced off our level yesterday. We've come up and retraced essentially to a 382. Stayed in the channel, and now we're at a 50% Fibonacci retracement level with all that other resistance going on. So that's at least where it's the next level is. So let's zoom in and see what happens. We get the first candle breaks through the 382. Remember, it was already respected back here. Next candle goes up. So instantly, what you're probably wanting to, thinking about is, you know, a short in that area would be a fantastic opportunity. 50 to 55, let's say, because of all that resistance. Even if you're wrong, the worst case scenario is you're probably going to hit the bottom of this channel, which allows you to be more than 15 pips in profit, so you could move your stop to break even. Okay, you don't have to give it a whole lot of room since you have a 200 EMA and all that resistance going for you. And if you're right, you could be very right, especially with big PPI numbers, much better than expected yesterday. Of course, you didn't know at that time you were also going to have better than expected CPI, but that's a different topic altogether. The next candle gets there. Or actually two candles in there, gets there. So you're up at that 4655 area at the top of that flag pattern channel. You're at the weekly central pivot point. That's this thick black line here. 50 is a psychological level, just like 100, okay? And you're at the 50% Fibonacci retracement level. A nice little short entry anywhere in this area. Now stop somewhere up here. Gives you a nice risk versus reward setup. Now you look at our pivot points for the day. I zoomed it out so it didn't show the whole day here yet. But we're pretty much, that thick black line is the daily central pivot point. Pivot theory states that if we begin our day at the central, typically we would see all the way down to the S2 for the day, which today is 144.82. Now that's a pretty big drop. I don't know if it's going to happen, but pivot theory says that. So what does Fibonacci theory tell us before we go any further? Let's back out a little bit to get it all on the screen here. Okay. Fibonacci theory says if we bounce off the 50% fib, we're probably going to head down to the 1382. And that's at 4513, which, if you notice, is pretty much an overlap with M1 for the day. So we have a good feeling about this, that we're probably heading to at least M1 today off this if we can break this area. So what happens? Oh, I got to re-zoom it in. Well, that kind of gave it away. Of course, I'm sure you've been watching the markets anyway. But I really want to zoom back to that moment where we hit the very top. Okay, It was at that top of that candle for just a brief moment, allowing anybody that wanted to short as close as possible to the area of multiple overlapping resistance. If you wanted confirmation, you could have got a little bit worse of a position, but only by a few pips, and you would have had to wait. Here you have a three-minute chart, 3 minutes to cast across after touching that 55 resistance area. If you're more conservative, you wait for 55 cross, and if you're even more conservative, you wait for the 21 EMA break. Well, you have it. So, worst case scenario, you're in probably right around 43 or so, give or take. 55 to 43 with a pretty tight stop. So what happens after that? Well, we go ahead and break the 5 EMA without much problem, and the you can see what's happening here. Head down. Now you have broken past the 21 and 55 EMA, which looked like they were going to cross and didn't, and you're at the bottom of that channel. Here's the thing. You are now, depending upon where you got in, up anywhere between, I guess, about 20 to 30 pips. Any way you look at it, far enough for you to go ahead and move that stop loss down to break even, whether it be here or maybe 45 or whatever. Now you have a no-risk trade, and there's nothing better than that. Sit back in your chair, put your hands behind your head, and see if this thing's going to break. Well, it plays around for a second. It breaks. Okay, that's looking good. Oh, all right. Well, at this point, you can move and start protecting 15 pips, which is what we call MAP, minimal acceptable performance, and then it's just a matter of trailing and stops. Now, you'll see a circle down here. I'm going to go ahead and just show you the whole move. These circles were pre-drawn before the move broke, trying to figure out where our targets might be. Now, these are targets. This is the M1 target we talked about, the Fibonacci target, and this is the S2 pivot target that we looked at. This is not necessarily a target. What that is, let me get back to it here, is an area of overlapping support that we would be we want to be concerned with, because you have a weekly M2 there. At the time, that gray line was a steeply up-pointing hourly Bollinger Band on the Euro-Dollar, and while the dollar Swissy, its counterpart currency, had a very steeply pointing down Bollinger Band on the hour right before price action. I'm not sure if you can really tell here. It was kind of right here at the time. As well as the psychological level of 4,600. And I am trying to find... Here we go. There was something... Oh, yeah. Here, the other thing was the... Actually, I think you can see it here. You see this little thin line? That is the distance of that channel. And if you take that distance from here, it overlaps with that same area, okay? As well as being M2 for the day. So it's M2 for the day. It's M2 for the week. It's that what we call not in a million years Bollinger Band. It's the psychological level. It's the distance of the channel. Not necessarily expecting to like take full profit here, but certainly expecting some level of support there. And you can see that we got it. It hovered, it waited for the 5 EMA for a little bit, for about 45 minutes, and then it just shot through. So at that point, we're looking for M1 as the target, our first target. Well, we get there a couple hours later, which is, it slows down at the weekly S1, retraces to the 5 EMA, and makes it right through, goes right through M1, doesn't even really respect it without any difficulty. And by the time the end of the London session comes by and the New York session's around, we're sitting here knocking on the door of S2. And we don't hit S2 before, and I'll let, I'm not sure if Kurt's, thought we did though. Yeah, actually we did. Kurt's probably going to do his New York video. We hit S2 right before, I believe, or right at the CPI release. So a lot of people might have gotten out here on this 5-8 cross, and that's okay. How many days do you see Euro dollar do 200 pips? I mean, come on. Some serious dollar strength here. Keep in mind that when we draw targets, it's not necessarily a to-the-pip target. It's a target area. See that blue line right there, that really thin blue line? That's a daily... There we go. That's a daily 55 EMA right there. So you have reason to believe that that could also cause a problem. Now, one other thing that's on the daily, if you zoom out and you just take a quick look, this blue line at 16... is also looking a lot like a head and shoulders setup. So we might be looking for some further downside in the coming days. And the reason you have this other line here is if you measure the distance of the top of the head to the neckline, that would indicate a break of somewhere down in that area. So we'll get to see if that's going to occur or not over the coming days, but it's pretty exciting when you see Euro dollar do over 200 pips. Now, it turns out later in the day in the New York session, we got even more out of it. But, that's after the CPI news, and that was during the New York session, but all you were just, you know, kept riding the 5 EMA and moving your stops. Now, a lot of people would have got out before the CPI report with the 5A cross, but guess what? You take a Fibonacci study of the move itself, and you're roughly, you broke a, your base of your candles out of 21%, and you're roughly out of 382. You're hitting that weekly S1. Maybe it looks better to show you here. You're hitting your weekly S1. See how you came down, you went up, hit your weekly S1, retested that weekly S1 pivot point, and gave us basically what we call a reload opportunity for people to get back in. And that happened right before CPI. So you could have reshorted at 145.40 or so before CPI and ridden that all the way down to S2 and then some, like many people did. So this is just one trade. The pound dollar, very similar situation. I'll go through this one a little faster. This is before the break. This is last night. You can zoom out and see yesterday's Fib study. It had come down. It was being very stubborn. If you see here, this level's 203.86. That's because, if you flick over, that's a, let me zoom it out so I can show you. That's a weekly central pivot point that's been very stubborn except for that little break yesterday. Okay, at 86. Very stubborn yesterday. And a little bit of a same deal with the flag pattern, a little channel going on. Well, let's see. We go up at 2 o'clock. We hit the, let me see if I can show you this here. There you go. We hit the 4-hour 55 EMA, which is what this blue line is right here. If we zoom back on the daily pivots, it's also a 1-hour 200 EMA and a daily M3. Now, anytime we see an M3, our primary target pivot theory from M3 is an M3 to M1 day. And obviously, you can see we have since far surpassed that. But initially, that is where it held. And the pound dollar pretty much did the same kind of reversal. Now, these kind of moves were you could take these either right at the point of overlapping resistance with the Fibonacci studies. In this case, it was a 786 at the top of the channel at the 204.50 psych level, hourly 200 EMA, and the 4-hour 55. Or you could have waited, again, for 3-minute confirmation, which, by the way, you would have gotten just a little bit later. So if you didn't take it right off the top with a pretty tight stop, then you just, you know, you lost about 10 or 15 pips of the move. No big deal. You wait for stochastic cross, 5-8 cross, maybe even a 21 cross, and you're in at 25 instead of 45. So, okay. I'll take that on a couple hundred pip move any day of the week, right? You zoom back in. And a 786 Fibonacci retracement tends to indicate as well either a 100% or a 1382. Let me just go ahead and zoom out the whole move. Fibonacci move, which 121 puts it at 203 at the psych level, and that would be our first target. Right, we don't know what's going to go that far, of course, but that's our first target. The next fib is 202.84, which would have been the 1382, and that pretty much, you can see M1 is 202.99, so that first one overlaps with our psych level. So we had a lot of reason to believe we were heading to M1 here. And as far as this other circle you see, that was, again, just like the euro, not a target, but an area that we knew we might have to be concerned with. And that's the, 203.50 psych level. It's also the S1 for the week, and if you notice, back it up, that was the area that we held on yesterday, the weekly pivot point. And also, this thin line here is the distance of that same channel, the same way we did the euro. So we had some reasons to believe it would stall there, but not necessarily stop there. What's the end result? I mean, you know what, maybe it's better to just show you here. The end result, as you can see, is over about 250 pips on the euro dollar. I mean, I'm sorry, on the, on the euro dollar. Even, it's just disgusting amount of pips. It's so many pips. And you really could have either picked one, traded a basket, and done any variety of things to make these pips. Gold, I won't go into the details of the move, was very similar type of break as well. Has since come down and touched 8,600. And if you look at a 4-hour, I call it gold. It's Aussie dollar because it's correlated with gold. That's why we call it that. You see you have a trend line for a while here, and you have yourself a little head and shoulders pattern on the 4-hour. Well, if you measure that distance to here, That takes you to 86, I think it was 86.47. Well, guess what? You've covered that head and shoulders. This 4-hour head and shoulders has completed as well. There were just so many nice USD-related strength moves yesterday. Today it was fantastic. And I'd probably just keep an eye peeled after the weekend. There might be more moves on the horizon. But if you'd like to learn how to plot these moves, like I said, these moves were plotted before they headed down, before they even hit 55. When the price was going up, we're looking for a short opportunity, and that area was right here. So if you'd like to learn how to plan these kinds of things ahead of time with a relatively low-risk, high-reward kind of situation, come visit us at FX Bootcamp. Love to see you there. I hope you guys had a great day. Have a great weekend, and have a happy holidays. Cheers.